Méline is in San Diego, California, to visit Lumati, a wellness center that focuses on health optimization, aiming to enhance clients' vitality at the molecular level.
I don't know what to expect. I'm open for anything.
Where there is no oxygen, there is disease.
But I don't expect that the thing will change in a few hours' time.
People have seen miracles with just this machine alone.
Come on in, I'm gonna take you over here.
Méline sits down with Dr. Greg Lane to check her baseline before treatment.
Seat there, perfect. What we're gonna do here before we start any of the therapies is get a baseline of where you are. All right, Méline, so what we're gonna do with this test, it's called an oligo scan.
Okay.
I'm gonna test 4 points on the palm of your hand, and what we're gonna do is use this machine. It's a little scanner, it's a spectrophotometry, and we're gonna test for vitamins, minerals, and heavy metals.
Okay.
Basically through light, so it's non-invasive. You won't feel a thing. I'm going to swab the palm of your hand with alcohol, mm-hmm. and just relax. And we'll let that dry for a second. So we always like to get a baseline of where our clients are with their nutrition, any heavy metals, any toxins, so we know that we're able to move the needle with all of our therapies here. Sit back, relax. I'm just gonna start by stretching your skin, and you're not gonna feel anything, just a little pressure, okay? There we go, is that okay?
Yeah.
Not bad. Spectrophotometry is using light to ascertain through the tissues the level of vitamins, minerals, and heavy metals. Light permeates through our bodies. We use it therapeutically, like infrared light or laser light. So this uses the same thing to measure the complexities of our tissues. This looks pretty good, really. I see heavy metals in everybody I test because we're subject to the water we drink, the food we eat, and the air we breathe, and that's how we get these things in our system. So aluminum is really the most concerning. It's showing high plus or into the excess, followed by silver, then cadmium, lead, and tin.
What will cause the high aluminum?
Everybody I've tested in the past 2.5 years has had high levels of some sort of metal.
Yeah.
And the way we get metal into our body is through the food we eat, the air we breathe, mm-hmm. and the water we drink.
Yes.
And then sometimes through the skin. So you should never drink tap water anywhere on the planet.
No, I don't. But the problem is now I know how heavy metal, what I do with it.
We go through a whole process here of recommending supplements that are based specifically on what you need.
Okay.
So we have solutions for that. Pretty good.
Yeah,
really,
good.
Really, very, very good. So, Méline, this is called a YWE. Mm-hmm. It's basically an ECG, electrocardiogram. So you're gonna put your index fingers on there and push down lightly.
This is really cool.
So we're checking the condition of her heart. You can see your heart rate, beats per minute, and your oxygen saturation is 98%. That's very good. So this test is called an in-body. So you can see it's measuring your weight, your skeletal muscle mass, extracellular water, total body weight.
The test is completed.
Perfect. Okay, so here's the result of your in-body composition analysis, and it looks pretty good. So here's your weight, and this breaks up your percentages, but this looks very good. So good job.
Good.
What we're going to do next is test your blood dynamics. We're going to test your cardiac output, your oxygen saturation, your pH, and a number of other things, all non-invasively through your fingertip, and we'll have Nurse Laura do that for us.
So this is the MTX, and this is one of our many tools that we use here to get baseline and also an end of day or end of your protocol assessment of what's going on in your body. And this particular piece of equipment measures multiple parameters. It measures your blood pressure, your oxygen saturation. That lets us know how well your body is absorbing oxygen. It tells me your blood pH, so I can determine, are you a little bit more acidic or alkaline, or is your body doing what it needs to do to regulate that particular parameter? And that's all just literally using light technology. and I can look to see your hydration levels. So why would that be important? These are all important because it helps me determine, well, number one, how much I need to hydrate you. If most people are dehydrated, if your viscosity is low, or if I need to refer you to a specialist. There's many things. We're not here to diagnose, but again, these are tools that help us get a baseline of where you're starting so that we can then see where you progress. So getting you set up here, I'm gonna put this in your lap, and then we're gonna do a measurement here. So you're just going to sit there for about the next minute and a half. What we say here in longevity and in wellness is that where there is no oxygen, there is disease. So it's called a state of hypoxia. So while that's measuring, I'm looking at your oxygen saturation looks great. Your blood pressure is good. Your pH level, you're a little bit on the alkaline side, but you're still within normal ranges. And again, that's a parameter that I typically would have to take your blood and send it to a lab. Now I don't even have to do that. So if I have these parameters and they're either too low or they're in a range that I'm concerned about, then I now have the tools to say to you, okay, I recommend you now go see your primary care physician, or maybe you need to get more labs, or maybe we need to hydrate you more. So these are all, again, just great tools for us to get a baseline to then see any areas that we need to adjust your protocol on. So you can see now it gives me a great color-coded range, and we go through and we look, and everything looks pretty good. You know, when you're hydrating well, when you're oxygenating, when you're taking care of your body, it's going to naturally adjust in these ranges. And that's the thing, is we are perfectly designed machines, okay, living in an imperfect world. Mm-hmm. So our body's constantly trying to make adjustments based on that. And that's why living in wellness versus living in sickness is really ideal. Yeah. So I tell people, don't wait till you get sick,
yes,
to do all of these things, because then it's harder to get your body out of that. Mm-hmm. You want to maintain wellness, and you want to support your body to do what it does best from day one.
Yes.
And it's never too late.
Yes, I feel what's great about all the tests I have done today is it's all very simple. I don't have to worry about any needles, but it do give me an insight of what's going on in my body, yes, rather than I self-diagnose this.
Absolutely. When it comes to the micro measurements, don't focus on that.
Okay.
This is all part of the big puzzle,
yes,
of things that we're looking at. It's just a matter of finding the people and the places that do it, I, yeah, think, and that's what's hard, is that it's easy to find the people who will treat your sickness,
yeah,
but it's a little harder to find the tools and the people that can support your wellness.
Yes, yes, yeah. Well said. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, Méline, let's come on into the table. You're gonna lay down, slip your shoes off, watch your feet, and go ahead and lay here with face up with your head on this pillow. You're laying on a PEMF mat, a pulsed electromagnetic frequency mat. So this mat sends electromagnetic frequencies through your body. So we always combine ancient and modern together.
Yes.
So traditional therapies and also the best of scientific advances. So we'll be doing a little acupuncture, and this is a light canopy similar to our light beds and our light wall. So it'll feel warm, and it also has therapeutic properties. Feel the pulse, very traditional.
Yes.
Yeah, your lung pulse feels pretty good. When was the last time you had acupuncture?
2 months ago.
Oh, okay.
What does acupuncture do?
It helps to regulate and balance all systems in the body.
Yeah.
So it can alleviate pain, it stimulates blood circulation, it causes an immune response, and treats everything from sleep disorders to asthma, to digestive disorders, to women's menstrual issues. So I'm gonna lower this. We're gonna put this over your eyes because it's going to get quite bright. Okay, just relax. And now you're having what's called photobiomodulation, or light therapy.
Feels really nice.
It feels nice, huh? Just breathe in naturally and out, and let your body relax as much as you can, okay? This is a Genesis 1 laser. Right now we're stimulating stem cell production.
It feels quite warm, but I feel like a gentle pressure,
mm-hmm,
on my bones.
There you go.
Méline heads to the hydrogen immersion pool, designed to infuse bath water with molecular hydrogen, allowing skin to absorb its benefits. This process claims to reduce oxidative stress and inflammation. Then on to photobiomodulation, a light therapy that claims to activate multiple systems, boost energy, stimulate collagen, and reduce inflammation.
One of the keys that we utilize here is called stacking. So the first thing I'm going to do is put on the helmet. These are diodes, and this is red and infrared, which can penetrate through the bone into the brain, and you won't feel anything, but what it does, an anti-inflammatory, helps to balance out and reduce inflammation, may improve brain function. So we'll run that. And the next thing is we also are going to utilize another part of the body here on your wrist. This is a nice thin area where it's very vascular, and we have a PBM spectra watch, and this has different light waves. You can see the colors. That on your wrist, so you'll get two various PBM photobiomodulation modalities in one. And then one of our signatures is, we love hydrogen here, it's the smallest molecule. You're going to place this cannula in your nose, then up over your ears. There we go. Relax, do a nice meditation, set a nice intention, and just breathe and let the hydrogen wash through you. It'll be through your lungs.
So what does hydrogen do to our body?
So hydrogen is known to help with recovery. It's known to help stimulate our body's anti-inflammatory responses. It's known to help heal the body. It can be extremely revitalizing.
So welcome to the Rasha Dome. The Rasha Dome is a very unique technology based on Tesla coils and scalar technology with quantum physics involved. And it's the brainchild of Dr. Jair, who was able to unlock the human potential and explore ways to elevate our consciousness and allow us to unleash ourselves to reactivate any DNA that may have been misfolded. We call it a DNA activator. At the root level, it just gives you the ability to give people better thought processes, better sleep, better ways to communicate with yourself, and to visualize the things that you want out of your health and well-being. Come on in, please. Yeah, just sit down over here. We will get you cozy. So one of the things it'll do, it'll recenter your mind, your body. It brings you back into balance. It activates your DNA, any misfolds you have, any aberrations you may have in the DNA, it will repair it. We've had autistic kids in here. We've had people with every type of chronic disease. They have over 4,500 documented studies and cases where people have seen miracles with just this machine alone. And we find it very, very useful with just about every type of condition.
It feels very relaxed. But it's not like a hot bath kind of relax. It's like a clear thinking kind of relax. This sound opens up a new space in my brain to experience different dimension in my mind.
Therapy's complete. David shows Méline the results of her treatments.
So we got your scans and we collected a bunch of biometrics on you, all real time. And it's all done in minutes. You came in at 13:16, which was 1:16 p.m. today, and we saw your oxygen saturation. We were able to get your mean arterial pressure. It went from 73. We brought it up a little bit. It was a little too low. We brought that up, which is good news. Your heart rate, basically the same. Your cardiac output, look at this. It jumped up from 4.3 to 5.1 liters per minute. So we were able to increase the amount of blood that's pumping through your body. So that actually went up about 20%, which is pretty good considering we only did all this in less than 3 hours and 45 minutes.
Yes.
Your stroke volume went from 54, which is kind of low, to 65, which is perfect for a woman. Also your blood viscosity, it was a little bit thin and we brought it up. Now it's perfect at 78 from 71. But here's kind of the key things here that I look at, is your red blood cell. Mm. Did we move the needle? And yes, we did. Your hemoglobin jumped up to 13 from 12.4. Hematocrit went from 38 to 40. And then your red blood cell count jumped up to 5.12. So you could see you're perfect right in the middle. This is the key. If you had a disease, if you had infection, all this stuff would be low. Look at your pH, partial pressure. You're born as a baby at 99.
Yeah.
You're 91, which is perfect. Normally after a week here, we get you to 99.
Mm.
My pressure is 120.
Oh.
and I'm 61 years old, okay? If I had cancer, I'd be in the 40s or 50s. So we could tell right away when somebody comes in if they're in a disease state without even doing anything. This is great. So your breathing, your lungs, your hematology, all of your markers look amazing. Your blood is perfect from a pH standpoint. And the most important thing we look at is your heavy metals and minerals. Yeah. You could see all the greens that she has here, but she has a lot of aluminum in her. Everything in moderation. So that's what I've done my whole life, everything in moderation. Mm-hmm. And when I stepped away from doing things in moderation, I gained 45 pounds. I started getting sick. I got very sick, and that's how my journey started, because I stopped moderation. So if your viewers come to our clinic, in 2 weeks, we could change your life.
I sure don't think anything will improve in a few hours time. I didn't know I'm going to have some heavy metal in me. I'm happy to know so that I can do something about it. Made me see the lights of the future of healthcare. It's definitely our China's passion to finding more cutting edge technology or treatment for different people's needs. So I actually looking forward to come back to do a whole 2 weeks of treatment to see what can change in me. Thank you for watching this new episode of the Human Well Project. It will help us a lot to subscribe and like this video. Looking forward to see you soon.